We set the roof. We set the roof on fire. We set the roof. We set the roof. We set the roof on fire. Slow. So bad, bad swimming in my bed. Off with that. Off with that.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. In today's matchup, passing may be at a premium, at least for one side. The Lions are top 10 at defending the pass. They'll be going up against the Bengals, who will need to solve that secondary. With that, we'll send it over to Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis. They've got the call in this Week 5 matchup.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the NFL sends us to the state of Michigan as we are inside Ford Field in downtown Detroit. Tonight, we wind up Week 5 with a good battle between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Detroit Lions. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Down. And his first look is incomplete. We get a look now at the offensive starting unit for the Detroit Lions, and one big target they have at tight end is Eric Ebron.
And they are ready for him to fulfill his promise because he was drafted to be a game breaker. Big target, guy with the block at the line of scrimmage, will really get downfield and make plays against defenders, overmatch them. They haven't seen enough of that yet. They want to come to the front in 2016.
Now a first down throw. Stafford is going to find his running back. It's complete. No gain, and it's second down. And the Bengals starting defensive unit now.
And Ndamukong Suh provokes a whole lot of conversation. But at the end, everyone agrees, one of the best defensive tackles in the NFL.
They'll fake it. Now Stafford. He's got time in the pocket. He's going to float this one deep, and this is going to be intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Very tough spot here for the offense to start. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. And here are the starters. Charles, what are your thoughts on Jeremy Hill?
He provides a thump in this offense. A great runner who goes inside and establishes a tone for his team.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
So second down, 3 yards to go now. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They'll look to throw. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down. And now the Lions' defensive starters.
Telvin Smith is a college safety who's transitioned very well to outside linebacker in the NFL. He runs down most plays.
They'll drop the throw underneath here to Hill. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. He'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's third down. And the Lions going with an extra DB here on third down. Looking to throw. And Adams has it complete. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
The goal of every offense is to move the chains, pick up first downs. A nice job finding an open receiver for a completion.
Back to throw now on first down. Caught on the right side by Adams. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And his throw here is incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
And this seemingly endless drive continues.
Third and five, so they bring in an extra defensive back.
Expecting pass. They'll set up a throw. It's grabbed over the middle by White. A pickup of five that time and a first down.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Complete to the right side. It's Eifert. 5 yards on the pickup, and they'll be faced with a third and inches.
All right, I'm doing my rudimentary math here. That's his third catch here in the first quarter. I don't know if it's just game plan or he's just finding his way open.
And maybe a little of both. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. He'll drop to throw. Going to throw right side here. Complete. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Their dangerous wide receiver. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Bengals are going to take a first quarter lead. The kicking team out now for the Bengals as they'll send this one away. This is taken at the three. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Here's the Lion offense now as they get ready to take over. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. To throw on second down is Stafford. He's got time. And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. The Bengals getting set to go. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time.
And this is caught inside the five. And they do get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield, but when you can pick it.
And he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bengals. Jeremy Hill, his first touchdown on the year. And the Bengals add on to their lead. And they're able to run it in. It started with the battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
This is taken at the three. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Lions offense, they get ready to head back onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And he comes back with one complete. And they thought they could exploit this defense with some really quick hitters, quick action. They worked on that in practice. We just saw it there.
And we saw them break it down to the fundamentals as well. Each position group had their own little work on it. You know, they worked on a drill here with the receivers, a drill there with the quarterbacks. Then they brought it all together, and now it's paying off in the game.
Going down the middle, and it's complete. A nice gain of 21 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. On first down at Stafford. And he finds a man with a crossing route. Here with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, as the Lions are in possession of the football here to begin quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Now a first down throw, Stafford. And he will find his man on the outside. 15 yards there for number 15. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence. Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling, some screens, some draws, some quick-hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
Give him three on the play, and that'll make it third and goal.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
Defense may be thinking pass. They come out in the nickel on third and goal. Now Stafford on third and goal. Oh, it's a touchdown if he holds on. Instead, it's fourth down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big time drop.
They'll look to throw here. And all the gamble fails. It's incomplete. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
6 yards on the pickup, and that'll make this a second down. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Oh, battled at the line and intercepted. And he will bring it back. And interception return for a Lions touchdown. Ah, yes, the old tip drill works to perfection there.
Ah, you're bringing back great memories. Used to love that drill. And a lot of times in practice, you work on it not just one tip, but multiple tips just in case the ball stays in the air for a while, to have an awareness and the ability to go up and grab it, and then you want to get some blocking support and end up in the opposite end zone.
In that tip drill, what do you yell?
For us, it was Oski. Okay, Oski was an interception.
For different teams.
Different teams have different ways of doing it. I've heard bingo, jackpot. The worst I ever heard, though, was Frankenstein. You don't want it to be a
too many syllables.
Word.
Yeah.
You want to get it right down and go. Oski is really the preferred word.
Oski. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage, and that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. They'll look to throw. Caught on the right side by Adams. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 15 yards there on the catch and run.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Underneath here to Hill. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play. But if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Second down now after the pass completion.
There we go now.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. The big fella. He's at the 50. The 30, 20, 10, 5, and he will score. Touchdown, Lions. So that is now two fumble return touchdowns. You talk about something that's going to drive a head coach crazy.
Without a doubt. But for the defensive guys, once you do it once, you create a frenzy. Everybody wants to get involved, and they got it done a second time.
And now following the timeout, we'll see if the offense tries to change things up. Stafford's going to try and throw for it. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This will be taken short. And solid field position here to start as they get it out to the 40-yard line. Now this Bengals offensive unit ready to see what they can do here.
At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
Hill, the lone setback. He'll come out throwing here on first down. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And this is scooped up by the Lions. And now he's got him in a great spot at the 8-yard line here, first and goal. Here's the Detroit offense now as they head back out onto the field. And last time, they had it fourth and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
Yeah, simple, a tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. On second. Oh, a hit. He lost the football. Stafford puts it on the ground. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You've got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10, right around the 9-yard line. Following the penalty. It's Hill. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Well, usually you don't think of the cornerback coming in for a no-gain play, but that's what we had there. Nice tackle.
Yeah, and how about the range, too? Coming from the outside part of the play, moving his way into the inside and making that play happen. No gain for the offense. Big play for the defense.
And he'll go out of bounds across the 35-yard line. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
Red zone opportunity. Really excellent job there of just going up and getting it.
Brandon, I'm a defender. I shouldn't be this excited, but what a play by the receiver downfield to elevate and make the catch.
A dump off now to Hill. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
It's a quarterback sneak. And no signal, but I don't think he got the surge behind center. No, he's going to be kept out of the end zone. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. And they'll try and burn some clock with a sneak. They're held again, and do we have a goal line stand brewing? It's third and goal. And we're going to get another timeout called by the Lions. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Well, they held them out on second down, and now here's third and goal. They come out here in the eye. Third and goal. Can the offense punch it in here from the one? No gain on the play, and what to do now on fourth and goal?
Partner, it's decision time now. I know it's still just the second quarter, but you have an opportunity to either kick the field goal or go for it and try and score a big-time touchdown. This is why the head coaches get paid the big bucks.
Now here's a sneak, maybe looking to run a little time. They try the sneak, but not enough push. He doesn't get in. And the Lion defense able to come up there with a goal line stand. And tough starting field position here. From the end zone, Stafford throwing middle, and it's complete. Give him 11 on the game there, and the Lions are going to have a first.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets. Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Here's Stafford now on second down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65. And now they come up and spike it to stop the clock. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. A final shot before the break. Stafford. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. So we have reached halftime here in a tight two-point contest. As we send you down to our EA Sports studios in Orlando, where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Bengal offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. Now it's second and seven. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. It's grabbed over the middle by White. A good pick up there of 20 yards. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage, so as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let them know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Looking to throw. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. That throw good for four. It's second down. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Back to throw again. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Back to throw. Now the ball comes loose. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. There's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And now another turnover as this one's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. After the interception, here's Stafford. Looking for his running back and he's got it. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that'll bring up second down. And the offense moving quickly to the line.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your...
Oh, a hit. He lost the football. Stafford puts it on the ground.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
From his end zone, Stafford on third and long. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they will take over with a football just outside of the 10 at the 12-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly. And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. That would have set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down on the sack. And it's never good to take a sack. You really don't want to take one down here in this part of the field, down near the red zone.
Not at all, because you're already pretty much assured of a field goal. But you take a big sack, it could push you out of range, and that's why defenses get a little more aggressive in this situation. They're almost conceding the 3 points. They want to push you back and try and take you out of that.
They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. And with that penalty, the offense in a tough spot here. 3rd and 13. Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver with his second touchdown of the game, 4th of the year. And thanks to the interception, the Bengals offense cashes in with 6. And oh my goodness, this is nowhere close. Well to the right and no good. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Now the Lions offense, they get ready to head back out there. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. A pickup there of 36. And it's good enough for a Detroit first down. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball. I've seen guys have games like this, and this is where you find out if you're great or not. Can you overcome some interceptions and still lead your team to victory? We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
He's going to loft one deep left side here, and he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on. Third down. First down marker at the 31. It's third down. Throwing on third down, Stafford. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. Eric Ebron, the big tight end, his intended target. And it's fourth down. They got pressure there and only rushing 3.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with 3 there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You drop an 8, where are you going to go with the football? Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Caught on the right side by Adams. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Offense staying ahead of the chains here, 2nd and 3. They come up in an empty set. 4 wide receivers, 1 tight end. They're going to look to throw. Able to get away.
That's why you keep the legs churning.
And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. They'll get a couple yards on that one. And that's going to make it 3rd down and less than a yard. Short of the sticks after that completion, and now it's 3rd down for this offense. They'll try and run for it. Here's Hill. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. They only get 2 there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. They stick on the ground on 1st down with Hill. Hill's hit, and he lost the football. And he's got some space here. And he's got daylight. to the end zone. A scoop and score on the fumble return for the Detroit touchdown. So they were down by a touchdown, probably just hoping the defense could hold them, maybe force the punt. Instead, they forced the turnover and take it into the house.
Well, the plan was perfect. That's exactly what they wanted. Instead, they got a lot more than that. Big-time capitalization by taking the ball away and putting it in the end zone.
Stafford's going to try and throw for it. And for the fourth time, and now off to the races, down the right side. A great read, and it's picked off. The 20. And he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as that play backfires in a big way. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And out now, here come the Bengals. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Jeremy Hill there was the intended target. And now it's second down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10.
And that one was knocked away, and I think the defenders are going to be a little upset with themselves. They made the play on the football, but that one felt like a forced pass by the quarterback. Thought he had someone open. He really wasn't. Maybe an example of having too much confidence in his receiver that no matter what, I'm like...
And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. So the Lions offense ready to go back out onto the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
On first down at Stafford. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. They go back to the air here after the INT. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Flushed out right. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Well, it was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He hits White, complete. And they're going to have this one up near the 30-yard line.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
It'll be a pickup of just two, and it'll make it a second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. To the left side here for Eifert. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Fresh set of downs here. Back to throw again. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and nine.
There's completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely.
I mean,
size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
You know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really did.
Oh, no, he lost the football. And the Lions have recovered.
I know you're looking at the scoreboard clock. We're getting near the end of this game. But they bring what was really called four-minute offense. And that's practice, being taking care of the football, taking time off the clock, not giving them a chance to come back. The bottom line is, what did I say in the beginning? Taking care of the football. That didn't happen.
Didn't do it. A costly turnover. Following the fumble recovery, Stafford is going to find his running back. It's complete. They'll give him a yard on the play, and it'll be second down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. To throw on second down is Stafford. Looking middle, and that's complete. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. A good first down call as the screen play gets him 9.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Now it's Stafford to the right side to Eric Ebron. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
Yeah, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time, as it's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 3 to go. Stafford on 3rd down. That's caught at the 3. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Lions have taken the lead here in the 4th quarter. He's got it. And this is indeed up to a 3-point lead. Now as they line up and kick this one away.
And this kick goes out of bounds, and that's obviously why the flag comes out here.
And now you can see the defense greeting the kicker as they go out to play. The starting field position for the offense is excellent, puts a lot more pressure on the defensive guys.
Yeah, and if the kicker thinks he's lonesome, he's really lonesome after a play like this.
Yeah, he better hope that he's lonesome, because whoever's standing next to him is probably on the defensive side, and they're none too happy.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Here we go now. 3, 9, 10.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. A dump off now to Hill. 12 yards there as they move the chains. And now he's closing in on 450 yards passing.
That's an incredible number. I mean, you're talking about the best defenders in the world that you're trying to throw the ball against, and you're creating that type of a number. Fantastic job, fantastic performance. And he's going to have to ice up his arm afterwards, too.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Give him 27 yards that time. And the Bengals are going to have a first and goal. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. He'll look to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. It'll go as nearly a loss of 10 on first and goal. So a disaster there. It goes as a 9-yard loss on the sack. He'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 14 yards, but they're still well shy of a first as that leads to fourth down.
Well, you know me pretty well now. You know what I want to do after that completed pass.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. So on four. And now the Lions going to stop us momentarily as they call a timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. And his kick is indeed good. And we are tied once again here in the overtime session. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
This one taken just inside the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team.
There goes Jeremy Hill. And he is in for the score. And it is absolute stunned silence here as they win it on the road in overtime. Well, you never know what you're going to expect when you come to the stadium to call a game. Sometimes you get good ones. Sometimes you get bad ones. Sometimes you get great ones. And that's what we had here. What an exciting finish on that last big play.
And I think that as we look at it, when you're talking about a great finish, which went along with a game that obviously was dramatic because we did get into overtime, what type of play calls do you have left? What have you not shown? Or what if you made an adjustment to what you've worked on all the way through that's going to give you the play we saw to win the game? Because I know everyone's thinking that that was something that they just drew up. It might have been something they've been working on, and now they got the right matchup.
So for the Bengals, they move back over 500 at 3-2 now on the year. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Baltimore Ravens. Meanwhile, for Detroit, the loss will move them back to 3-2 on the year. And they will get a home date next week as they will take on the Dallas Cowboys.